5 stick.
Yeah. I have an offer to make to you, Bill. You can earn an exemption for yourself if you forfeit this game right now by hitting the ball out of turn.
Let's go home.
Last night's game was videotaped by many different cameras, and I thought I would show you this.
Before Bill could make his decision about the exemption, I went ahead and kicked the ball out of turn.
Briv has made the choice to end the game and forfeit the money for the group.
Has the game changed for me? Perhaps. Do I still think I have morals and ethics and integrity? Yes, I do.
Darwin.
A group of strangers working together to earn up to $1 million. That in the end, only one of them will win. One of these players is the Mole, a double agent we hired working for us against the other 13. At the end of each episode, the players take the quiz, 10 questions about the Mole. The quiz determines who stays and who goes because the player who scores the lowest on the quiz is executed and is sent home immediately. Up to $1 million hinges on discovering who is the Mole. Watch for the hidden clue to the identity of the Mole.
I'm so annoyed that there's only 2 girls left. It's gonna be a tougher game, I think. I really hope at least one of us makes it to the end.
I'm just tired of not being in control. I've always been in pretty good control, and now I'm not.
It's going to be a game of observation from here on out, and that's it. That's the only thing that's gonna get me to the end. The only thing. That and an exemption would be really nice.
I've done as much as I can do to stay within my boundaries ethically and morally. I'm gonna try my best to continue staying within those boundaries, but I realize now that you got 5 players. 4 players are not the Mole. Time to play.
On a day of much needed rest, the final 5 players are given an opportunity to explore the sights of Rome.
Oh, you're so cute.
I like to let them see where we've been, see? Maybe they'll be dreaming about tonight.
We have 5 players. One of them is the Mole. So everybody is playing the game harder, more deceiving, more conniving than they have in the past.
I've been without a coalition partner since Alavia left, and it's been pretty lonely since then. It really, really helped me to have someone to bounce ideas off.
I think at this point, everybody is ready to play the games, cast their lots, and see how they come out. We don't need a lot more questions answered. We sort of got our favorites picked, and we're going to go for them. Whoever's left in here by the next game is going to have to be real definitive, and obviously, you better be right.
Curious to see how they're going to offer the exemptions now.
Lucky son of a bitch, whoever gets it.
$80,000 or an exemption. What do you do?
Exemption.
I think it'd be really cool if somebody pulled this off with no exemptions.
You're
right. No, I already got one, so I'm not happy about that.
I think
that'd just be really cool. Here's your exemption offers and stick it.
Welcome to Piazza Duomo. This is home of L'Aquila's Daily Market. Today we have a game that's worth $30,000. I need 2 players who like to shop.
I think that's us.
Yeah. Really redefining gender roles here in this game.
All right. Breaking all barriers.
All right, you 2, come with me. The rest of you, stay here.
Good luck.
Good luck, girls.
Good luck, girls.
Today, you get to have a 200,000 lira shopping spree in this market. 200,000 lira is about 100 U.S. dollars. The only restrictions are you have only 1 hour to shop, you have to buy at least 10 items, and you have to drive the hardest bargain you can. Here's 200,000 lira. Italian dictionary. So your hour begins now.
appointment?
25.
How about if we buy due?
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 50.
No. 40? 40.
The hell do they have to do?
What do you think they're buying?
We have to eat what they buy. That'd be nice.
5? 3? Para 3?
3 pezzi.
Por favore.
Pero?
Okay, puedo pagar para... Para más caso, para... Anything.
I found it difficult to bargain with the vendors, partially because of the language barrier, partially because I felt that they were getting annoyed that we were trying to get some items for free or for some price that they felt was unreasonable.
14. 14.
40.
What else are we going to buy?
25 para foto, por favor.
I wouldn't say that we drove a hard bargain. I was just feeling victorious that we saved, you know, 50 cents here and there.
We need two more items.
So rugs.
I'm all you.
Ah, gotcha.
There's only two anyway.
What are you doing, girls? What are you buying? Why are you buying it?
After Dorothy and Heather complete their part of the shopping game, Bill, Al, and Bribs come down to see what they purchased.
Let's see what you got.
So what'd you buy?
Prickly.
Watch out, guys.
I see you went for a variety.
Yes.
Clearly. Yeah. It is now your guys' turn. It's your job to sell these items.
Why do you pick eggplant in Italy when all they use is tomatoes and everything? Hatchets, some really ugly dresses, a big squeegee. Who the hell's, what are you going to use that for?
You have until the close of market, which is about 1 p.m. today, to sell what you have and make a profit. We gave them 200,000 lira to spend, so 200,001 lira is fine. As long as you make a profit selling what you have, you win the game and earn $30,000 for the pot.
Griff, figure out how to say, I need to sell these items. Please buy. You can get that down. Golden man.
Having finished their role in the game, Heather and Dorothy now get to observe the men try to sell their wares.
We need to sell. We need
mucho
to sell.
Mucho dinero para este.
Yeah. Mucho dinero.
Y un abrazo también. And hug as well.
I think it's going to be hard for them.
We didn't realize this was going to happen, and we picked out very strange items. Bed sheets. Pink bed sheets. I think we would have been better at that, actually.
Selling
girls.
What's that?
If one of the girls... We're down here trying to sell. Bam, bam,
yep,
bam.
Yep, I totally agree. After about an hour, I said, we're not selling any of this stuff. We're not getting anywhere. You know, I think I sold a wire brush to a guy.
I sold the wire brush?
Did you?
Yeah, for $3,000.
Okay, so we sold
two cactus. How much money we got there? Okay.
It's only 193,000 lira to go. We're close.
While the guys struggle to make back the 200,000 lira, the girls turn their attention to winning a much more lucrative prize.
I want two girls to make it to the final.
Yeah, I do too.
I think that would be so awesome. And that would be an accomplishment in itself. Obviously, we'd both want to win, but if we didn't...
I'd be happy.
I'd be happy too.
We've been saying things back and forth, such as we have to do something to make sure the girls stay or the girls, you know, sisterhood. And we never really took each other seriously until we both just sort of looked at each other and decided, okay, well, do you want to do something about it? Well, okay, let's do it.
You're not the mole, right?
I'm not. But convince me you're not.
Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
Let's think quickly about what we're going
to
do.
The key is to get them to fumble on the quiz.
All right, who do you want to knock out first?
Prego comprare questa cosa!
Prego!
Less than an hour remains, and Bill, Al, and Bribs are having trouble selling their items. While above the market, Heather and Dorothy's new coalition begins to take shape.
Okay, say I was a mole. It still wouldn't hurt you to work with me, right?
It's true. How do I know you're not going to misdirect me or misdirect them to knock me out?
Yeah.
You could be a very sadistic mole, going specifically for victims.
If I had my Bible right here, and that means, like, everything to me, I swear I would put my hand on it and swear. And that doesn't mean anything to you, but to me, like, I would never do that unless it was the absolute truth. I swear on my ring. I am not lying. I am not. I swear to God, I'm not the mole.
I needed Heather to convince me that she wasn't the mole. I think the fact that she approached me was enough in my mind to convince me.
Do you know how ridiculous that would be to pick me?
After an hour or so and realizing that there was no way in hell we were gonna sell this stuff, we tried to start selling the items that we had on us. Al put up his New York Mets hat. Bill put up his watch.
Ah, here's some insect repellent. Good stuff.
We can sell the shoes!
We start thinking, what about our brand new Echo shoes? They're a pretty popular brand here in Europe.
Prego, comprare questa cosa!
Okay.
50?
Okay. Same thing.
We haven't paid for these yet.
No, no, eh?
50.
Uno.
No, 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 not two pairs.
All right,
take them. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
I can't believe I'm wearing shoes.
They took my shoes. I couldn't even sell two pairs of shoes at the right price. I got ripped.
How about we sell kisses, man?
Getting desperate.
Baccio. Due mille.
That's not my kiss, but you know.
Uno bacio, due mille. Uno bacio, due mille.
Scarpa?
Uno bacio, due mille.
This is embarrassing.
If I was an Italian woman, you'd have to pay me to get a kiss from that man.
Uno bacio, due mille.
Uno bacio, due mille.
You know, times are rough, man, when a guy can't even sell a kiss.
Hey, what do you know? Do you know anything that would help?
About what, who they're going for? Absolutely nothing. Do you think people ever believe anything anyone says?
I've believed a lot more than I probably thought I would. What can we do to increase suspicion?
Ha visto bella! Buena preso!
The players don't know it, but their next customer brings with him a test.
Buena scarpa. Buona scarpa.
Buona scarpa. Hey, somebody.
14.
Yeah, what was that?
He left his money.
Okay. Signore.
Hey, tell him.
Signore.
No, go tell him. Go tell him.
No,
hey. His money.
Signore.
There you go.
Good job, Al. That was the right thing to do.
Yeah, it's the right thing to do.
Oh, I don't want
another test of our faith. Like, I didn't even see the guy had the book in his hand. It was Romeo and Juliet.
The Romeo and Juliet book obviously was a clue, going back to the think or sink game.
15 minutes. Oh, boy.
Hurry up!
Yeah, you sold
tutti,
for
tutti, centoventi! Tutti, centoventi.
Centoventi.
That's 1 o'clock. We're screwed.
It's not for whom the bell tolls, it tolls for you.
It's only for me.
You know, I just felt like I was getting the hang of it. I almost...
Yeah?
No.
70, 80, 95, 96,000.
That's it.
So you guys only made 96,000 lira. You guys lost 104,000 lira. So obviously you did not win the game. I'm sorry you did not earn anything for the pot in that game. You clearly do not have a future in sales.
We didn't have to spend 2 hours making fools of ourselves, tell you that. That's all it is.
Well, there was another element to the game, a little morality test. Someone came by, a man came by, dropped some money.
Yeah, 20,000 lira.
Even though you could have profited by keeping the money, you chose to do the right thing, you returned the money, so you earned $10,000 for the pot. So $10,000 for the pot, simply because of the morality test.
Take it. Take what we can get here.
If there was any sabotage in the buy and sell game, it would have had to come in the buy part, because we were left with everything else. I don't think that Bribs, Bill, or I stood a chance of selling that junk.
Some of the items that were bought, I couldn't have sold to my mother, and she loves a bargain.
Let's think quickly about what we're gonna do.
The key is to get them to fumble on the quiz.
All right, who do you want to knock out first?
Coming up on The Mole, the next betrayal.
If the evader retrieves 5 of these thumbprints in under 30 minutes, the evader wins an exemption.
Out! There, run!
Go, 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 go!
Here she goes!
Santo Stefano, a small hilltop village with narrow, maze-like streets, alleys, and tunnels, is the playing field for our next game. The players gather atop this 17th century lookout tower.
This game is worth $50,000 for the pot. It's kind of like hide and seek. One player must evade capture by the others. This player is called the evader.
another player known as the Tracker must hunt down the evader.
9 mole thumbprints have been planted throughout this small town. If the evader retrieves 5 of these thumbprints in under 30 minutes, the group gets no money, but the evader wins an exemption. If the Tracker captures the evader, the group earns $50,000 for the pot. 3 lookouts will be on this watchtower, helping the Tracker try to locate the evader. The evader will be wearing this backpack. For the Tracker to capture the evader, just have to remove that. That's a capture.
Heather is chosen as the evader. Before the game, we asked the players who'd they like to see win the pot other than themselves. Heather was the choice by majority. Now she'll have a shot at an exemption.
Heather, since the game began, you've been wanting to earn an exemption for yourself?
Absolutely. This is such a critical round, I think. I mean, if I could get down to 4, that would be so close, and it would be totally up to me to make it to the finals. But this round is a little scary because I think people are not quite as confident as we feel we should be at this point. So an exemption would mean the world.
What the other players don't realize, Heather, is that you will also have a walkie-talkie. You can use that to eavesdrop on their communications. So this is the map. It has the location you're now at the watchtower, as well as the 9 mole thumbprints.
We asked the players who they least suspected of being the mole. By an overwhelming majority, they chose Al. He will be the Tracker.
I thought to myself, boy, I'm not fooling anybody in this game, and how the heck am I gonna win? And I also thought to myself, I'm fooling all of them. This might be easier than I thought.
Unbeknownst to the others, Al is about to be offered an opportunity that could prove very valuable.
I'm going to give you a special incentive to capture Heather's flag. If you capture Heather's flag in under 30 minutes before she gets the 5 mole thumbprints, not only do you earn $50,000 for the pot, you earn an exemption for yourself. All right? I know you realize how important an exemption is at this point in the game.
Yeah.
All right? So here's your walkie-talkie. Good luck.
At this stage of the game, an exemption is worth, you know, a free pass to the next round. And I think that's gold. That's gold.
Okay, the game begins in 5, 4, 3, 2. Let the game begin.
All right, let's have one to the east, one to the west, one to the south.
Yeah, you that's think? Fine. Yeah. And we've got that thing.
All right, I got it over here. Al, tell him to come to the center. Bill?
Ask where Al is.
One of the lookouts must first spot Heather moving through the village before Al is allowed to start tracking.
Al, can you copy this?
I copy that.
Okay, the game started and we're watching for her.
We'll tell you when to go.
Keep an eye out, Dorothy.
This is a lot harder than I anticipated. The map is very hard to read, and most of the corridors are very small and narrow and crooked, and I realized pretty fast that the thumbprints are definitely in the tower's view.
Bill, what's the plan up there?
Right now, we're just trying to see her.
We can also see thumbprints. There's some right up around this tower here.
Okay, so everybody's around the tower looking down right now?
That's what we're doing. We're just watching for her. We can't do anything until she shows her funny little head.
You get ready to go. You haul toward the tower.
Copy that.
Tell him to take off towards the tower.
Come on up towards the tower, all in.
She's southwest of the tower, so as you come, you want to keep the tower on your right and head toward her.
Copy that.
Watch her coming down here. Dorothy, she's over here.
She's right here in this area, right in front of me. Tell him to hurry.
Guarantee he's coming as fast as he can.
Keep falling. Keep coming toward the tower. Now, we haven't seen her again, but we can see a bunch of thumbprints.
Bill, who are you talking to? Have you spotted her?
Yeah, haven't you moved? Oh.
I'm on the move now.
On the move?
Yes, I told him to move.
We spotted her southwest of the tower. She picked up a thumbprint, and she is moving, so you need to come toward the tower and keep the tower on your right a little bit and look down in those streets.
As soon as I hear that they've spotted me, I'm flustered, I'm nervous, I run to the next location, I grab a third thumbprint, but I feel totally helpless.
Got her, or you just see her?
Oh, I got her. I got her.
Good job.
Very nice. Very nice.
That's 5 minutes.
Yeah, good job. Hey.
All right?
I'm just tired of this game.
It's a game. It's just a game.
I watched Heather just melt away. I felt terrible, but the game was the game because she just... It was like the wind that just came right out of her sails, and she just pretty much just gave it up.
Sam, this is my one chance, you know?
No, it's not. You've gotten this far. You didn't get this far on exemption. You hadn't got one yet, right? And you got this far, so don't think that. Come on, man.
Miss Link, no matter where they were all in your view, so...
Oh, I'm sorry, Heather!
I know you guys are happy, but...
It's a hard game. It's a hard game. You got three.
Just put one exemption, just one.
I'm sorry, Heather. The game is the game.
I know.
I felt terrible. I said, boy, she's on the verge of cracking. I'm not even just from this game. I think it's the entire game.
So, Heather, how many did you end up getting?
I got three.
Three multiples? Mm-hmm. Well, you guys did a good job. Earned $50,000 for the pot. Heather was denied exemption. An exemption, however, was earned in this game. Al, do you want to tell them about it?
My extra incentive was not only to nail the flag for the 50 grand, but if I was able to do it successfully, I got an exemption.
If any player is anywhere near as confused as I am, I think it might be Al. And knowing that he isn't vulnerable to be executed in the next round, it makes me really scared.
The game, however, is not over. I'm going to make you guys an offer. If you'd like, you can have another try playing the game and possibly double your money. So you wouldn't just earn $50,000, you would earn $100,000 for the pot today. Big sum of money. Heather would again be the evader. She would get the exemption. You can pick anyone else to be the tracker. The tracker is not eligible for an exemption. Right. Keep the $50,000 already. If you guys choose to gamble for the money and Heather wins, that means two players will have exemptions going into this next execution. And there is an execution tomorrow.
Same rules as before.
Same rules as before. It's a vote. It's majority rules. I'm going to start with Heather.
Up on the mole, the next betrayal.
What's your slow? What's been your slowest time? Nothing. 1:30 something.
Okay. Mine's slowest time is 1:22.
Man, I'm screwed.
After quickly being caught and missing out on her exemption, Heather and the group are offered a second chance.
If you guys choose to gamble for the money and Heather wins, that means two players will have exemptions going into this next execution.
Same rules as before.
Same rules as before. It's a vote. It's majority rules. I'm going to start with Heather. Heather, do you
obviously,
want to play again?
Yeah, obviously, yes, I do.
Okay, Dorothy?
I vote no.
Bill?
Yes.
Troops?
Yeah.
Al?
Oh. We got 3 yes already. That's a majority.
I'd like to hear your vote.
My vote? Yeah.
You have to pick a tracker. Who do you want to be your tracker?
Ribs.
My entire adult career has been judging people and judging people's capabilities. There is no doubt in my mind whatsoever that Bribbs can win the second game. Just none whatsoever.
Okay. Bribbs, Heather, follow me. The rest of you stay up here. Al, take off your...
I believe that most of the players voted yes because they didn't have confidence that I could do it.
This is tough. Because I wanted to get it because I feel bad for it, but I want Bribbs to get it because it's a lot of money. I'm kind of torn.
I feel confident enough as the tracker to be willing to have two exemptions going into this next round.
I know where a few of the thumbprints are at this point, so I have an extremely different strategy.
The game begins in
5, 4, 3, 2, go.
Get him.
Good eyes, Dorothy.
Good eyes.
I got you. Come on, show yourself.
Bribbs cannot begin to look for Heather until the spotters in the tower see her below.
Yeah, she's still got 25 minutes, so she's taking it slow and easy and sneaky.
Keep your eyes there.
Keep a sharp eye out. I'm gonna need all the time I can get. All she has to do is make a mad dash down that street where I pointed out a few of those thumbprints and then it's gone.
We don't see her. Now she's laying low.
Thumbprints is gone, Dorothy?
Yeah.
Dorothy said one of the thumbprints is suddenly missing.
We didn't see her.
Let's rotate stations. Rotate around.
I'm up in the tower with two people that I don't trust, and I think either one of them could be the mole.
Pick my spot.
Come over here quickly first.
Dark, pick my spot.
No, come over here first.
Nobody on my watch is going to start letting people slide around. So everybody rotates.
Go. Whatever.
Saw her?
Yeah, she went right up through here and took a left, right down there.
Which way should I go?
Hold fast a minute, man.
Yeah, Bribbs, I would just hang close to the tower.
Then get your breath a minute until we see her again.
15 minutes down.
Out of breath, completely exhausted, but I still see a bunch of the thumbprints there, and so I'm trying to replay the map in my mind and where all the other thumbprints are located, and I knew that she probably had four.
I take the fourth thumbprint, and I'm not spotted. I do it very carefully, and I realize that in order to finish the game, I have to get one more thumbprint.
I went down there and did a clean sweep around the left. I didn't see her.
Now she's laying low at the moment.
So I just take my time. I listen on the walkie-talkie to see if I can get a feel for where he is.
I'm gonna go take a look right here.
I know Bribbs is coming straight for me, so I hide behind a wall. If Bribbs would just turn the corner, he would find me immediately. But I just hold still, and I wait, and wait, and wait.
Heather!
I think she's going around the long way through town.
That sneaky little Texan.
Come on, show yourself.
So she has to break this barrier to go over there. Exactly how many flies are left over there? Three?
Yeah, Bribbs, there's three over on
the... Heather has four thumbprints. We can see the other five. It's a matter of how can we outguess Heather.
Point out where the flags are that are left.
So you guys know, there are 9 minutes remaining.
Heather,
looking down the corridor and I realize it's right there. Even if they spot me, Brooks won't get me in time.
Here she is, here she is. She's coming to get the one that you saw, Brim. She's on her way.
You ran right into her.
Oh, poor Heather.
Good for us, but poor Heather.
Jeez, that's twice, and she was so close again.
I feel bad for her.
Yeah. I think that Heather thought in her mind that the game was won. She had the thumbprint. She had the exemption within arm's reach.
I'm furious when he tags me. I'm so angry and furious because I tried. I gave everything I had, and I failed again. To have two chances in exemption and to fail both times is not a good feeling.
I had four. I was just talking. No, I mean, you did your job. I was pissed off at myself because I was so careful.
How's it feel to win $100,000 in a day?
Good.
You ever made $110,000 in a day?
No, once. It's a little old. No, it's a really good day
for the pot. Bad day for Heather.
The thought that was going through my mind was not that we won $100,000 in one game. It was that I prevented Heather from getting an exemption.
You guys took a gamble, paid off. $100,000 in this game. Earlier you made $10,000, so it's $110,000. Pot's now at $486,000. Not a bad day.
Not a bad day.
That was a great game.
It was a great game.
That's a fun game.
Who wants to go to bed? Raise your hand.
I'm gonna brush my
teeth. Because he's in the mall. He doesn't want us to share.
While the men go off to bed, Heather and Dorothy stay up and begin to talk strategy.
First love, first crush, yeah. First crush is Barbara. Man, I'm screwed.
Dorothy's an extremely intelligent person, and I pinpointed her, you know, besides being the mole, as being definitely somebody that had a great chance of winning.
Just to make it to the finals would be like so. I really don't have high hopes.
I don't either.
Tomorrow I think I'm going to get a big can. It's going to be a matter of seconds. I feel very unconfident.
What's your slowest? What's been your slowest time? That's
anything that 130 something.
Mine's slowest time is 122.
I don't know. I'm so screwed. I never knew how fast people were going. Really scary.
I've been told very many people completely truthfully what I've done on the quiz. I mean, my strategy throughout the game has been to tell half-truths anyway, because I think people will just assume you're lying.
I'm so pissed off at myself for the way I acted today, because I could have totally, in hindsight, used that to my favor, but I was so upset. Like I couldn't. Yeah, you totally could have, but, I mean, it's too late.
If I am executed tonight, I will be so angry. I will be kicking myself for months, probably, because I was that close to staying around.
Coming up on The Mole, The Next Betrayal.
You know, you've all just taken the 10-question quiz about the identity of the mole. The player who answers the most questions wrong on that quiz is the player who will be executed tonight.
So how does it feel to win the exemption now?
Wonderful. Not gonna lie, it's great. I'm relaxed.
Not stressed out about tonight at all.
And there's something about saying there's almost $500,000. But that's, for some reason, seemed a lot more money than $376,000, whatever it was. That's real money.
Are you more nervous about this one than any other ones?
Early on, you had all kinds of fears and all kinds of things. And now, we all know what we know. We all know what we're going to say. And I haven't seen anything that's going to change it. And so I'm just going to go do it. And if I'm right, I'm right. If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. And I'm not a hell of a lot of money.
First, how about you? How do you feel?
Feel fine.
You ooze confident.
Oh, yeah? Good.
I wish you guys luck. Good luck, everybody.
Good luck. That's fine.
It is time for the quiz. 10 questions about the identity of the mole. Question number one. Did the mole sell their shoes during the buy and sell game?
Prego, comprare questa cosa!
Number two. What role did the mole play during the evader game?
even though Bribbs hasn't done anything to sabotage the game, I still find him extremely suspicious.
As a player, obviously, Heather would want the exemption, but she could easily fake that she wanted the exemption. The feeling that I got, at least, was that she really, really wanted that exemption. And if that wasn't the case, well, then she's a hell of an actress.
Number three, in what position did the mole get off the van at the Fontana di Trevi in Rome?
I think Bill voted to play the game again because if he is the mole, it doesn't matter to him whether or not there's another exemption.
Number four, what was the mole during the buy and sell game?
After seeing all the items that they had purchased, and after knowing that we'd have to sell all these items, I was extremely suspicious.
Number five, what kind of socks was the mole wearing during the Evader game?
Keep on, keep coming toward the tower.
Bill, who are you talking to?
Al missed the cue. He was waiting for the command go, and I assumed he was on a dead run.
Number six, while in Rome, the mole got a henna tattoo on what part of their body?
I thought that I'd be a lot more confident about who the mole is. Not to say that I don't have a very strong suspicion, but I thought I'd be dead set going into this execution.
If I am executed tonight, I will be so angry. I will be kicking myself for months, probably. I had a nightmare about the Evader game, and I kept replaying the scene of me reaching for the thumbprint and Bribbs grabbing me.
Number seven. In which position was the mole interviewed today? Number eight, if the mole could live in any other country, where would it be and why?
Let's rotate. Rotate around. Bump Dorothy, quickly. Dorothy, take my spot.
I assumed he had a reason, or he wouldn't be, you don't rotate willy-nilly. And as it turned out, he did have a reason. He immediately suspected Dorothy of deliberately not seeing Heather.
Number nine, what is the mole's favorite game?
Dorothy could be playing me. She still could be the mole, and I still could be the fool. She's played a great game.
I think Heather could be the mole as well. She, like Bribbs, is charming, plays the role of the player very well.
Number 10, who is the mole?
Dorothy, Al, Heather, Bribbs, tonight you face your 10th execution as a group. Bill mentioned it at dinner, but I think it bears repeating that you've all made it very far in a very, very difficult game, and I hope whoever is executed tonight feels no shame in leaving. You have all played the game very, very well. Al, as you know, you are exempt from tonight's execution, so there's no way you will be executed tonight. You are guaranteed to go on to the next round. For the rest of you, you know, you've all just taken the 10-question quiz about the identity of the mole. The player who answers the most questions wrong on that quiz is the player who will be executed tonight. I'll begin entering your names into the computer. If a green screen appears after your name has been entered, you remain in the game. If, however, a red screen appears after your name has been entered, you are the game's 10th victim. You have to take your bag and leave the game immediately. All right, let's begin. Dorothy. Al has been exempted. Two players remain who are eligible for execution, Heather and Bribbs. Bribbs.
been cleaning out my grandfather's garage. If I get executed, this should be passed on. Because what I have here is the original mole killer.
I had a blast at the time of my life. I wish I could have stayed and played because I have a feeling the next game's gonna be pretty exciting.
Are you happy with how you played the game?
I'm very happy with the way I play the game. I didn't have to compromise myself too many times. And, you know, I enjoyed myself while I was doing it, so.
He definitely was a very good friend, and I'll miss him a lot. But we're winding down, and I'm not gonna lie, I'm happy I'm still here.
Guy was willing to try anything at any time, never say die. I'm gonna miss him a lot. Never quit. Funny guy with a lot of heart. I'm definitely gonna miss Bribs.
He loved the game. He loved the game. I know he had wanted him to win, but he loved the game.
He really was the most selfless person I've met, just even in general, not even in this game. And I really, really, really like Bribs a lot. I'm very sad that we're gonna lose his company.
Yeah.
I think Bribs is one of the most caring players out of all of the original 14. You know, he was always there to help you with your bag or, you know, to make sure you're okay if you're feeling sick. You know, just check up on you, and I think that was really nice. We needed someone like that in this type of game.
I've said it before and I'll say it again. His daddy and mama did a heck of a job.
Yeah!
The kid is grounded. I like him.
And I'm gonna do you right, Bribs. I'm gonna make sure Texan wins this game. Definitely. But good luck to you. I'll miss you. I really will.
There's only four of you left. Heather, are you the mole?
No, I'm not the mole.
Al, are you the mole?
No, I'm not the mole. I couldn't be holding this can if I was the mole.
Dorothy, are you the mole?
Nope, I am not the mole.
Bill, are you the mole?
One of those three is lying because I'm not the mole.
Next Tuesday.
I can't believe I'm still here.
It's the semi-final round, and one terrifying night will decide who gets the clues.
Ed!
And who's going home.
I didn't come here to eat bugs.
The Mole 2, only four suspects, three shows, and one big secret left. A brand new episode next Tuesday at 9, 8 central on ABC.